Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Largo Cultural Center. We'd like to remind you that the use of flash photography or recording devices of any kind is strictly prohibited. If you have gum or candy, now would be the time to unwrap it. And why not share some with your neighbor? If you have a cell phone or beeper, now would be the time to turn it off. Unless, of course, you have Sprint. You don't get reception with Sprint anyway, so it really doesn't matter. We invite you now to sit back, relax, and enjoy Jean Michaels and Phyllis Murphy's The Queen of Bingo!
Mary and Joseph. Never seen so many people wanting to play bingo here at St. Joseph's. No, no, it's all right, Lonnie. We're putting the overflow out here in the hallway. Oh, and here she comes now.
Oh, hi there, Father Mac. They got you working tonight, huh, Father?
Oh, to be sure, they're getting their money's worth out of me this evening.
How much are they paying you?
A couple of bags of popcorn and some milk duds. I'm helping out over the concession stand. Well, God bless you, darling. And good luck to you.
Well, good luck to you too, Father. With you. Is that, no, Cindy? Oh, I can't believe you finally got her to come to bingo. It works.
Jig, jig. All righty, daddy, she's a-working. Hello, everybody, and welcome to St. Joseph's regular Tuesday night bingo. Glad you could make it here tonight, and in just a few minutes, we'll be getting started. But first, those lovely ladies over at the concession stand wanted me to tell you that they've only got about 6 hot dogs left, so you better hot put it over there if you want a hot diggity dog, okay? Now, there's a blue 57 Chevy pickup out in the parking lot, and the lights are on. I guess that's yours, Dot. Okay, okay, folks, that's all the announcements for now. Get ready for your early birds. In just a few minutes, we'll start the early bird special.
Sis! Sis, where are you, sis?
Babe, I'm out here.
You're out where?
In the hall.
In the hall?
What on earth are you doing out here?
Now, don't get excited.
This place is packed! What's going on around here anyway? I haven't missed a night in 10 years. I missed a couple of weeks. I come back, I don't even know the place. What the hell is going on around here? Didn't you call Laura Gilbert and ask her to save our seats?
I tried for 2 hours. The line was busy. Now, just calm down.
Calm down. Did you see who's sitting in my seat?
I tried to get here early, but I was babysitting the boys.
Did you see who's sitting in my seat?
Little Kristen says to say hi to her favorite Aunt Babe.
Did you see who's sitting in my seat?
Oh, for God's sakes, babe, of course I see you sitting in your seat. I'd have to be blind to miss her. My God, she's sitting in my seat, too. She's bigger than the both of us put together.
You're right, she is.
Sit down and get your card spread out. You won't be ready for the early bird.
Oh, you're right. This is gonna be my lucky night.
Has it gotten colder out?
I don't know. Why?
Well, I just thought maybe the temperature dropped since I left the house an hour ago.
Yeah, well, this is the first I've been out all day.
Are you feeling okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Coach Anderson was asking for you when I was buying our door cards. He says to me, where's that good-looking sister of yours? Babe? Oh, God. I thought I was talking to myself. What are you doing down there?
Is he still around?
Who?
Coach Anderson.
No. He's got football practice tonight. That Coach Anderson's a doll. He's got a heart as big as a gymnasium. Looks like he lost some weight since Marion died, though. He needs a good woman to fatten him up.
God, the thought of it.
What?
Never mind.
He says to me, if Babe didn't come back to bingo pretty soon, we were considering bankruptcy. She's a real winner in my book.
He said that?
Well, it's true. You do win a lot.
No, I don't.
Well, yes, you do.
No, I don't. I used to, but my luck has been lousy lately. I haven't even won a regular game of bingo in over 3 months. That's why I stopped coming. I never win anything anymore. I can tell you, sis, things haven't been going too well for me lately. But I swear to God, this is it. You hear me, Lord? This is it. Sorry about the swearing. If I can just win tonight, it's going to change my luck. Mwah. And everything will be okay. And if that cow thinks she's going to get lucky because she's sitting in my seat, she's got another think coming. What the hell is this?
Oh, Flo McFeeney was selling the jackpot specials, and I bought you 12. Isn't that what you usually play?
What are you talking about? I bought 4 sheets on my way in.
No. Those are for the regular specials. These are for the jackpot.
What the hell is she selling them now for?
Will you take it easy with the what the hells? Father Mac is in the concession tonight. Hey, Father.
What the hell is he doing here?
They were short-handed. That's why Flo sold the jackpot early. Half the parish is working the bazaar, and the other half's at the retreat.
Yeah, well, I hope one of those retreaters is praying for me. God, I hate sitting out here in the hallway. Gives me the creeps. You know, I heard Lonnie went to hit her good luck charm with her dauber the other night, and it ran away.
Her good luck charm?
Yep.
Her good luck charm ran away.
It was a mouse. Somewhere around here, there's a little white mouse running around with a purple head.
Come on, I've sat out here lots of times, and I've never seen a mouse.
No! Sorry, I couldn't resist. God, I just hate it out here in the hallway. Oh, you can smell the boys' locker room even over the pine saw. I can't even see the board from here.
Oh, that's okay. You never miss a number anyway.
Could kill that fat one for taking our seat.
Shh, she'll hear you.
Yeah.
She heard you.
Oh! Oh, hi, hon! Oh, you're looking good, sweetie. I love your hair. Now try losing 100 on each side and I fit into these folding chairs.
Well, look at you, you silly goose.
What? What?
You're still sitting there with your coat and scarf on.
Oh, am I? Oh, yeah, I am.
Oh, aren't you dying of the heat?
Yeah, I guess a little.
Well, take it off. God, it makes me hot just to look at you. Here, let me help.
Hey, take it easy, sis. I'm not a little kid anymore.
Oh, yeah? I've been dressing and undressing you since you were a baby. You'll always be a little kid to me. Now, stand up. Now, come on. Settle down. Flo said she knows you always want the first two specials off the top and the two off the bottom, so that's what she gave me.
That Flo is a doll. I always did like her. She brings me luck. Last time I won the 500, she sold me the special. Trouble. That turkey Flo's married to is calling tonight.
Oh God, what did Flo ever see in him?
What is she seeing him now?
He thinks he's God's gift.
You know, Laura was telling me that one night when they were closing down the concessions after the late birds, he tried to get into Janet McNamara's pants.
Oh, you're kidding.
No! She was back in the storage room putting away the corn chips when he walked in and pinned her up against the popcorn machine.
Oh, my God, I never heard that.
He planted a big, fat, juicy one right on her lips. And he chews, you know.
Words fail me.
Ooh. Then Laura said that Janet said if it hadn't been for her panty girdle, the kitty cat would have been out of the bag, so to speak.
Poor Janet. And it's only been 6 months since Dinky died.
Yeah, well, she's lost a lot of mileage since then.
Well, I don't know what it is about these men when they get around a widow. I think they're doing you a favor. They probably think, that poor old thing, I'll just give her a little kiss.
Yeah, well, he better call me a winner tonight or he's on my list. Oh, hey, this thing's almost out of juice.
Oh, here, hon. They had daubers on sale at Kmart, 3 for $1. After I bought those, I found out they were giving them away at the Moose to try and get people to come.
Yeah, well, they'd have to give away a lot more than a dauber to get me to go to the Moose.
Well, not only that, they're playing the Big Diamond there now.
You're kidding.
No. Dolly played there last week, and they got up to 57 numbers for the coverall.
So what are we doing playing here?
Supporting the St. Joseph's Athletic Association.
I'll tell you something. The St. Joseph's Athletic Association had better start supporting us for a change, or we'll go to the Moose! I'm not really Moose, but I do get horny.
Oh, babe! Oh, cut it out. I know what you mean, though. Costs too much if you don't win some back every now and then.
Oh, it's not the money. It's the principle of the thing. I mean, nobody from this parish ever wins the 500 anymore.
Oh, I hear Dolly's sister Roxanne won it at the Elks last week.
See? They're not afraid to give it to a Catholic over at the Elks. Here, they think the Protestants will think they're playing favorites. Well, I guess they figure the more we have to sacrifice at bingo, the sooner we'll get to heaven.
We'll probably go to hell for playing bingo in the first place. This is gambling, you know.
Yeah, but it's not a sin for us, only for those Protestants. Only trouble is they don't know a sin from a rat's ass.
You are a real piece of work tonight. Oh, here. I glued together your early birds. They're gonna start any second.
Well, thank you, sis.
You're welcome. My God. Aren't you hot with that heavy sweater on?
No, I'm not hot with this heavy sweater on. If I were hot with this heavy sweater on, I'm an intelligent enough person that I would take it off.
Okay. Geez, I just don't want you to get overheated and catch a cold or something.
I'll be fine.
Well, it must be me. I'm probably having a flash. Oh, my God, I am having a flash.
You know, I was thinking on my way over here tonight, I must be about due. It's been almost a year since I won the jackpot.
Well, I've never won it.
I mean, everybody thinks I win so much.
You win a lot more than I do.
Well, there's a reason.
Yeah, I don't want to hear
it. Oh, all right, all right.
May I have your attention, please? Can I have two of you lovely young ladies or able-bodied gentlemen come up here and check the balls?
Woo-hoo! Oh, here we go. Oh, I'm beginning to feel like a new person already. God, it's good to be here.
Oh, I'm glad you decided to come tonight, hon.
Oh, I thought I'd go crazy sitting at home these last few weeks.
Did you watch a lot of TV?
Nah, it's nothing decent to watch.
In accordance with the Bingo Association's rules and regulations, we're required to stop selling the paper specials before the first number is called.
Oh, I couldn't wait to get back to bingo.
I've missed you. There's nobody to talk to when you don't come.
We play a clean game here at St. Joe's.
Now, what is he stalling for?
Because nobody will get off their duff and check his balls. I mean, why doesn't Joe go up? She's sitting right on top of the caller.
Come on now, step right up. Don't be shy.
Oh, good Lord, get a load of this. She's prying herself out of our seats. What is she wearing?
Stretch pants.
Poured into doesn't quite say it.
When was the last time you saw the weave in polyester?
Those seams are doing the work of a yoke of oxen. Does she have any kids?
Well, you know she does. Four. Two by her first husband and two by her second.
Oh, the thought of it.
Now, babe, how do you expect to win tonight talking like that?
Oh, you're right. I say a novena all week that I'll win, and then here I go. Boy, if I were that big, I'd kill myself.
All righty, daddy, ladies and gentlemen. The balls have been checked in. We're ready to go with our early bird special. And the first number is... under the I, 19. I, 19. Under the B, 4.
And
B,
after.
4. Under the N, 36. N, 36.
Hurry. I'll never be able to keep up in the coverall.
Under the O, 66. O, 66. Under the N, 42. N, 42.
Slow down, will you?
This is too fast for senior citizens.
We can't keep up with you.
Sorry, folks. I guess I'm just a little too fast for you.
Yeah, right.
Under the O, 70.
Oh!
Okay, just getting around. Have a little fun.
Yeah, that makes one of you.
Under the B, 8. B, 8.
Woohoo, I'm down to 2.
Already?
See, I told you I'm hot tonight. Come on, G48.
Under the G,
48.
47.
Shit!
G47. Under the I, 18. I, 18.
Woohoo, I'm down to 1. Come on, G48.
One more G and somebody's gonna get it.
Me.
Under
me,
the
me,
G,
48.
50. G50. Bingo! We have a bingo, ladies and gentlemen.
I don't believe it. Maybe she made a mistake.
50, 4, 19, 36, 70.
Well, that's a good bingo! Are there any other bingos? Are there any other bingos? Are there any other bingos? That's one bingo, one early bird special at $50.
And she's sitting in our seats.
Oh. It's only the early bird. Let her have it.
Yeah, I'd like to, but she's bigger than me. Oh, my God, she's the queen.
No, she isn't.
She's the queen of bingo.
She is.
Oh, I think I'm going to die. She's sitting in our seat. She won the first game, and now she's the queen.
Will you listen to me? She is not the queen. She won the early bird. You have to win the first game of regular bingo to be the queen.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Oh, babe, did you see who's here? It's Lonnie's girl, Cindy.
Oh, hi, Lonnie.
Hi.
Cindy?
Oh, you're all grown up. Look, she's all grown up.
You better believe it. Oh, sure, Lonnie. Don't worry. We'll show her the ropes.
Show her the ropes? She's Lonnie's daughter. She must have played bingo before.
No, she lives in New York.
Don't they play bingo in New York?
Oh, sure, they play. They just don't pay anything.
How much?
$25.
Cheapskates.
It's nice to see somebody getting started. Oh, God, I hope she doesn't do something stupid like yell bingo before she's got one.
Yeah, they're merciless when you do that. Well, she's just gonna have to learn the hard way like the rest of us. How many cards has Cindy got anyway? Four cards! Four cards, bless her soul. Four cards, give me a break.
Well, she's gonna start someplace. She can add a few more next time and work up real gradual.
Sis, she's never gonna win anything playing four cards. How old is Cindy anyway?
Let's see, she graduated high school a couple years after my Doris.
Oh, no, she's a lot younger than your Doris.
No, she's not. I remember her selling Girl Scout cookies when the kids were still home.
So?
So, she was Girl Scout age. How old are Girl Scouts?
Girl Scouts can be any age. Look at Angie Kopech. She's made a career out of being a Girl Scout.
Well, how old is Angie?
Oh, I don't know. Oh, she's over there in the corner. See her? You tell me.
God, geez. I guess it's a long time since I took a good look at Angie. Is that a wig?
Of course it's a wig. She hasn't worn her own hair in years.
Somebody should say something to her.
Are you volunteering?
Okay, clear the decks, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to start the first game of regular bingo.
It's about time!
What were we talking about?
Oh, Cindy, that's right. How old is Cindy?
Well, didn't Lonnie graduate with you?
Yeah, she was a bridesmaid at my wedding. Now, come on, you know that.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
She was nursing a kid at the time. Cindy!
All right, so what year did that blessed event occur?
Yeah, well, I can always remember the year he left me, but I gotta work backwards from there. It was almost 10 years ago, 2 days before my 42nd birthday, the louse. We were living over on Elm Street. We were there for 5 years. Then before that, Chestnut for 3 years. Then the trailer park for 2 years. What's that so far?
Five, three, two, 10 years.
Oh, yeah, and then 2 years at Mom and Dad's.
Ooh.
So that would be 12 years ago, 10 years before I was 42. 10 and 12 is 22. Cindy's 22.
God, it's like pulling teeth.
What's that?
Trying to remember anything anymore. If we get any older, someone should just take us out in the backyard and shoot us.
Oh, one more thing. Next week, the Knights of Columbus are having a raffle in conjunction with our annual Oktoberfest. So don't forget to buy your tickets. First prize is a trip to the Holy Land. Secondary prize is a trip to Las Vegas!
Woo!
So you get your choice between heaven and hell.
Come on and get ready. They're going to start the first regular game.
Crazy when you do that.
What?
Why do you have to put all those chips out?
What do you mean?
Why do you have to put all those chips on your free space?
Just to remind me, those are already covered.
It says free right on it.
I know.
So why do you need a chip on
it? So when I glance across the cards, I won't waste time looking at the free space.
So don't look at them, that's all.
I don't.
Good.
I don't look at them because I got them covered with chips.
It's not like you're playing 30 cards or something. I mean, you wouldn't have time to play 30 cards playing like that.
Babe.
12 cards.
I hear you, and I'm not biting.
Look, sis, it's not the 12 cards.
13 with the door card, it's 13.
Okay, it's not the 13 cards.
13's my lucky number.
I know, it's not the damn 13 cards.
Oh, really?
Okay, go ahead, play 13 cards. How about your way, play 13 cards?
Thank you so much.
But you're never gonna win anything.
I don't like playing more cards, I like 13.
But sis, you've got to play more to win more.
I don't want to win more.
What? You don't want to win more.
I mean, of course I'd like to win more, but I just like playing, you know? Don't you just like being here sometimes?
No.
Oh, I don't know. It's sort of exciting.
Exciting? Bingo? Oh, I mean, it's exciting when I win. I mean, that's exciting. Anyway. Look at the fat one, for instance.
Why? Is she excited?
No, but she will be. And you want to know why? Because she's just getting started. Because she's going to win big tonight, and then she'll be excited. Anyway, look at her.
It's pretty hard not to.
Yeah, I know. But think about it, sis. She plays 50 cards. 50 cards. And have you ever been here on a night when she didn't win something? I mean, think about it. She always wins something.
Yeah, that's true.
And that's because she plays 50 cards and she plays to win.
We couldn't play that many cards at once. It makes me too nervous.
She doesn't waste time putting chips on her free space.
I heard that.
Yeah, well, think about it. Think about it.
I'm thinking.
Remember Margaret Freely?
How could I forget?
52 cards.
One for each week of the year.
She never used a chip.
Or a dauber.
God.
She was really something.
I mean, she would sit there reading a book, and they'd call a number, and she'd go like this. Then back to her book, and all of a sudden she'd yell, bingo! And sure enough, she had a good bingo every time.
How did she do it?
Well, Lonnie was telling me one night at the Napoli, Margaret had had a few when she got to talking about it. She said that it was all based on
the B system.
The B system. What's that?
I don't know. Nobody knows now. She took it with her to the grave, God bless her soul.
Isn't that a shame? To be 6 feet under with a secret like that.
Yeah, well. She supposedly taught her daughter Caroline the B system before she cashed in her chips, but well, you know Caroline. She just didn't have the talent for it.
Be sure your tickets are showing just in case any state bingo inspectors decide to show their faces here tonight. It's a law, you know.
Come on!
They just want to know how many cards you play and make sure their numbers tally with ours. It's for your own protection, really. And remember, your door cards are good for regular specials.
Come on, fartface! Shoot those balls and let's get going!
Babe!
How you doing? Good to see you all tonight. Thanks for coming out. Oh, I'm sorry, sis. I got ants in my pants tonight. I mean, they waste so much time around here telling everybody all the rules and the regulations. My God, I could say them in my sleep.
They've been cracking down lately. Too many illegal bingo games going on.
Yeah, sure. Maybe over at the Moose or over at the Elks, but not here at St. Joe's.
Here at St. Joe's?
You gotta be kidding me. Don't they know we invented this game?
Just listen, because they made a few changes around here.
Changes? What do you mean changes?
Alrighty, daddy, folks, here we go.
Nothing. They just changed a few of the rules to see when we get going.
Our first number tonight in regular bingo is, under the eye, 22.
22.
I-2-2. Under the B, 4.
Before what, turkey neck?
B-4.
Oh, he heard me. Ooh. I don't care, he is a turkey neck.
Under the I, 19. I-19.
Same old numbers.
What's that?
Calling the same old numbers he called in the early bird. It didn't happen then, it don't happen now.
Under the G, 48. G, 48.
Well, there's a number he didn't call before. If he had, I'd be $50 richer.
Under the O, 67. O, 67.
Bingo.
Will you look at that?
Beginner's luck.
4, 19, 22, 48. 67.
Watch out now, Cindy. That's how they get you hooked.
That's a good bingo. Are there any other bingos?
She's the queen.
Well, that's one winner of our first game of regular bingo. And that goes to a pretty new face in the crowd. Who is that? Oh, mercy. Oh, Float tells me that's Lonnie Conklin's daughter, Cindy. She's all grown up. Congratulations to Cindy. She's our queen of bingo for tonight. Remember that whoever wins the first game of regular bingo is the king or queen of bingo. Now, you be sure to remind me to give the queen a dollar every time her pretty little winning number is called. Cindy's winning number was 0-0-0-67.
Oh, 67.
Get ready for our next game of regular bingo.
I can't believe it. Of all the luck.
This time it's a double bingo. You have to get two rows anyway to win.
Here we go again.
Under the eye, 20. Eye 20.
Well, speaking of being lucky, my number came in yesterday.
419?
Well, you know I always play 419 straight.
Yeah.
Under the O, 69. O-69.
That's my lucky number.
Oh, babe, that's dirty. But yesterday, babe, I got up late. I didn't know what day it was or anything. And I leaned over and looked at that digital clock Bob and Helen got me for Christmas. And it was blinking on and off. 9:14, 9:14, 9:14.
So you played 9:14?
No.
Oh.
I figured this was an inverted sign that I should play 419 boxed and straight, and I won $400.
Damn!
You're the only one I've told.
Oh, what are you keeping it such a secret for?
The kids have been hounding me about wasting my money.
That's your money.
I know, but Helen keeps saying I play too much bingo. She's got Bob on me now.
Oh, what business is it of theirs?
Out of the N, 36 and 36.
He says to me Sunday night, Ma, you're not really going to play bingo again, are you? I said, well, I was thinking about it. Why?
Sunday night? Where do you play bingo on a Sunday night?
Under the I-24.
I-24. But there's this new place that just opened up over in Southfield. It's called the Bingo Palace.
The Bingo Palace. Woo-hoo! Where have I been?
Oh, it's wonderful. They play the Big Diamond and the Postage Stamp.
You're kidding.
Anyway, Helen says to me, how long's it been since you won a game? Whoa, babe, I lied. I'm going to have to go to confession before Sunday, but I said that I won last Saturday at the Immaculate Heart of Mary, and she says
to me... You played at the Immaculate Heart of Mary?
Oh, well, Joanne needed somebody to go with her, and I wasn't doing anything, so I said I'd go with her. Anyway, after I lied and said that I won...
Wait a minute, you played at the Immaculate Heart of Mary.
Yeah, so you played at the Immaculate Heart of Mary.
Well, yeah, sure, you know, I mean, a few times when I couldn't get here, but I never played both places in the same week.
Under the B-12, B-12.
What the hell? Hey, I hear the fat one play someplace every night.
Yeah, I heard that. So anyway, Helen says to me, funny you never mentioned it.
What? Funny you never mentioned what?
That I won last Saturday at the Immaculate Heart of Mary.
You won last Saturday at the Immaculate Heart of Mary?
No! I just told the kids that. I lied. And Helen says to me, funny you never mentioned it.
Well... they're probably just afraid you're going to spend all your money and they won't get it when you kick the bucket.
Under the B-9. B-9.
Sometimes I feel like I'm the kid. They think bingo's a joke.
Why don't you bring them with you sometime? You know, let them see what it's like.
Well, I think everybody who plays bingo is senile.
Oh, yeah? What do they do for kicks?
Doris says to me, what do you want to play bingo for, Ma? Let's go to Dollar Days at the mall and then to the Big Boy for the fish fry.
And she thinks that's exciting?
I guess so. Well, I should count my blessings. They're good kids, basically. I just hate to have to sneak around.
Under the I-17. I-17.
God. If they knew how much I really played, they'd have a fit.
Under the N-32.
I don't know what I'd do without bingo. I've never been very lucky at winning things, but I've always been a good loser. I play poker with Sam, and he'd have a fit if I won. And I play Candyland or Old Maid with the kids when they were little, and they'd cry if they didn't win. They must have gotten that from Sam.
Under the B5.
I never won a church raffle when I was a kid or even the cakewalk. You know, I remember when Babe was 8 years old. She drew her own name in a raffle at Woolworth's department store. But me, I never won anything until I came to bingo.
G-52.
So why should I have to lie to my own kids? I was just walking out the door last night when Helen called and says, Ma, I know it's last minute, but could you babysit the boys for a few hours? So I said the seniors were having a potluck and I was up to my neck in baked beans. I guess she understood. Truth is, I was really going to the Elks for the bingo jamboree!
Oh, 62.
Men have a better chance of winning things. They get to play all those games, sports, and win all those trophies. Well, we even Babe's always had to win. She'd never admit it, but she hates to see anybody to win more than she does, especially me.
I-22.
That night I won those two specials back to back. I felt like queen for a day. Babe pretended like she was happy for me, then she suddenly got a headache and had to go home. So I went to the Napoli with Louise and bought pizza and pitchers of beer for the whole bingo crew. It really felt great to say, "It's on me!" and slam that $100 bill down on the table. It's nice to feel like a big shot once in a while.
B2.
So why should I have to explain myself? I'm not asking anybody for anything. I can take care of myself. I only have me to cook and clean for. There's nobody else. And who wants to go out on a date? Well, not that anybody's knocking down my door. But who'd even want it? Some old fart wanting me to take care of him? Imagine trying to get used to somebody new. Their habits, your habits. No thanks. Once was enough for me. Give me bingo any day. I'm having the time of my life.
He calls another O and it's gonna go.
O-67. O-67.
Give the queen a dollar.
Thank you, ladies. And the next number under the I, 23. I-23.
Bingo. Bingo!
Oh, it's a split.
Well, who won?
Well, it looks like Maxine Carmichael is splitting with Maxine Carmichael.
Well, she has no business yelling bingo twice like that. Makes you think it was a split.
She always was a show-off.
How does she look?
Well, Maxine always did look a little like the last robes of summer left standing alone.
Yeah, I know. I gotta get a peek for myself.
Babe, watch out. You're gonna knock chips on the floor. Get up and look.
Well, I don't want her to catch me looking.
What's the big attraction?
Well, I saw her at the mall last Saturday, and it looked like her face was all bashed in. I figure maybe Sal caught her fooling around again and beat the shit out of her.
Well, lean in here and look. She's talking to Lonnie and get a quick peek.
Are those stitches in her forehead, or are her eyebrows really shaped like that? Oh.
God, they must be stitches.
Pray they're stitches. Oh, shit, she saw us.
Oh, hi, hon. You won, huh?
Congratulations, little devil.
You shouldn't yell bingo twice like that. I thought it was a split.
That surgeon ought to be shot.
I don't know. I have to get a closer look, but from here it almost looks like an improvement.
Okay, folks, that's $45 for our winner.
What's the matter with her ears?
Oh, stop it, babe. It's just terrible to stare at someone like that.
Yeah, I know. You're right. I don't know. Maybe it's me, but I could swear one of her ears is bigger than the other.
Get ready now. In just a minute, we'll start the middle bird.
Middle bird? What's that?
Oh, it's something new they started.
I thought it was intermission. I gotta go to the bathroom. How much money does it pay?
Oh, they give you prizes. It doesn't pay money.
It doesn't pay money? Forget about it. I gotta go to the job.
I'm gonna go get me a pop or a hot dog. You want something?
Now, you know I never eat when I play bingo. Besides, I had a little something to eat before I came. Don't worry, I'm taking it outside. You think I was a mass murderer or something.
Yes, folks, we got a new game here at St. Joe's, and here's Father Max to tell you all about it.
All right, folks. Welcome to St. Joseph's. Ooh, we got a large bunch out here. My name's Father Mackenzie Muldoon, but most folks around here call me Father Mac or Mac Daddy to my altar boys. No, I'm just kidding, officer. And as most of you already know by now, I'm your new assistant pastor here at St. Joseph's. Just fresh out of the cemetery. Seminary, sorry. A couple old folks up here in the front row. Anyways, I'm new here at the church, so feel free to say hello whenever you get the chance. Anyways, getting down to business, the folks over to the Publix market have been kind enough to donate another one of their finest, freshly frozen, self-basting turkeys for our middle bird tonight. Oh, no, this isn't the real turkey right here. This is one of those South Beach diet birds you've been hearing so much about on the TV and in the newspapers. Yeah, we used to bring out the real turkey, but then Monsignor's hands got all frostbitten, and he started to develop the arthritis. Then, of course, there was that unfortunate event involving Sister Mary Clarence, the puddle on the floor, and the frozen turkey with the pop-up timer. That was very messy. So now we just bring out the fake bird to give us an idea. But don't worry, you'll be getting a real turkey by the end of the evening, or my name's not Francis Mackenzie Muldoon. But it is. Now, by the looks on some of you new folks' faces, you're wondering to yourselves, Father Mac, what the heck is a middle bird? Well, I'll tell you. It's actually something we developed right here at St. Joseph's. You won't find it at any other parish in this town. The whole state, I'd venture to say, so I don't want to see any of you sinners heading over to the Moose looking for Sunday dinner, understood? All right. Now, we're going to take out our bingo cards. Does everyone here have a bingo card? You'll find them stuffed, as it were, in your program. That's it, darling, right there. If you don't have one, put your hand up to Jesus, and one of our ushers will kindly give you one. Okay, we're going to be playing a regular game of bingo, which means you got to get five in a row, either up, down, side to side, or diagonal. No, darling, that wasn't blessing. I was just explaining the game. So five in a row, and remember, you can use your free space too. Which, by the way, does anyone know where the free space comes from? Jesus. That's right, Jesus. Saving your souls from eternal damnation and helping Catholics win bingo since biblical times. So you can use your free space, but no four corners. That's for those New Age pagans, and we'll have none of that stuff here at St. Joe's. Now, once you get five in a row punched out, you yell bingo real loud and clear. Which brings me to my next announcement. You gotta punch the numbers out. Don't rip them off, otherwise I won't be able to tell if you got a legal bingo or not. So you lose if you rip, and you win with a good solid punch. And anyone I catch ripping off numbers is going to have to stay after and sweep the whole hall. That should take care of that. All right, now let's try yelling a practice bingo for all those atheists and agnostics that snuck in here tonight. Sure, I saw you come in, darling. All right, on the count of three, one, two, three. A room full of Methodists. Come on now. Let's show some Catholic gusto. One, two, three. There we go. Now, why can't we respond like that on Mass on Sundays? That's what I want to know. All right, here comes the bad news, folks. There can only be one winner, and do you know why that is? There's a good Catholic education. We only have one turkey. So only the first person to yell bingo is going to be our winner, all right? That's all the announcements for now. Let's get ready to play our middle bird special.
Okay, here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Our first number in our middle bird is, under the N, 37. N37. Under the G, 59. G59. Under the O, 63. O63.
Oh, someone's off to a good start here.
Under the N, 41. N41. Under the N, 35. N35. Under the G, 53. G53. Under the I, 17. I17.
You're lucky Jesus gave you that free space.
Under the B, 11. B11. Under the B, 12. B12. Under the O, 72. O72.
How old are you? O72.
Under the O, 67. O67. Under the B.
There you go. Give the queen a dollar.
5. B5. Under the I, 20. I20. Under the G, 60. G60.
We're not playing the coverall, folks.
Under the O, 69. O69.
Oh, all right, hold up here. Looks like we have a bingo, but don't go throwing your cards away. That could be one of those drunk Episcopalians yelling bingo this and bingo that. Bingo was his name, oh. All right, let's pass it down, sir. And what's your name, sir?
Peter.
Peter. This is Peter's card. Under the B11.
That's a good number.
Under the I21. Oh, I'm sorry. Under the I-20.
I-20 is a good number.
Sorry about that. I'm 21, so. Under the N, a free space from Jesus. Under the G, 60.
That's a good number.
There we go. Under the O, 69.
That's good bingo.
Wonderful. Round of applause for our winner. Congratulations to you, Peter. You know, the moment I saw you walk in here, we made eye contact, and I knew you wanted me to give you the bird. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. By the end of the evening, you will receive your turkey, all right, Peter? Now, we're going to be taking our regular 15-minute intermission, so I want to see each and every one of your smiling Catholic faces over at the concession stand, because all the money we make tonight is going towards a good cause. Half of it's going towards the Bishop's Relief Fund, and the other half is going towards new protective equipment for our boys and girls field hockey team, so make sure and eat up. All right, thanks so much, folks.
Coach Anderson's here. He's taking a break from football practice, and he wanted me to remind you that the Pep Club is sponsoring a car wash next Saturday, October 3rd, from noon to 5 at Nick Murphy's Sunoco Station. That's down on Wabash. And just another reminder, folks, our St. Joe's Chargers will be playing the Southfield Bobcats at Kellogg Field this Friday evening at 8 o'clock. So try and get out there and support our Chargers. So long, Coach Anderson, and thanks for stopping by. Okay, okay, now get ready for our next game of regular bingo. Oh, one more thing. Next Sunday, after the 12:15 Mass, the Our Lady of Fatima Society's sponsoring their annual $5.98 all-you-can-eat spaghetti and meatball dinner. That's $5.98 for all the piles and piles of pasta, rich tomato sauce, trays and trays of garlic bread dripping with butter, and all the big, fat, juicy meatballs you can eat!
Just the thought of food, I am so disgusted with myself. Why did I do it?
And our first number is under the B11. B11.
I've been dying to get back to bingo. It's just killed me sitting at home these last 2 weeks. I said to Sis, go ahead, buy my card, save my seat so I won't back out at the last minute.
And 40.
I even planned what I was going to wear the night before. I got out that cute plaid over blouse I bought on sale last week. And my black knit pants. The only pair of pants I can still fit into. The biggest pair of pants I own. Size 16.
I 16.
I got home late from work and I panicked. I ran upstairs and I grabbed my black knit pants and I hopped around on one foot trying to get the other foot into the leg when my toe got caught in that patch I'd ironed on where my thighs were wearing a hole and I started to fall over. So I gave one last desperate shove to get my foot in the floor, and I split the entire leg, leaving me nothing to wear.
B2.
That's when that scary feeling came over me. I ran down the hall and got on the bathroom scale. I got right back off again.
G4.
1958.
I got back on the scale, but this time I leaned way back with my feet hanging off the edge. No difference. I got off the scale and ripped off everything I was wearing to see if that would make a difference, but even without my bra and control top pantyhose, I still weighed the same.
Oh, 71.
Oh, I was sweating. I wanted to die. I felt empty, 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 and nothing would fill me up. I felt weak, like I was gonna faint.
To the G55.
Next thing I knew, I was standing in front of a cupboard, naked as a jaybird, eating spoonfuls of marshmallow fluff with Hershey's chocolate sauce drizzled all over it. An entire bag of stale saltines smothered in peanut butter and grape jelly, alternating handfuls of chopped walnuts and butterscotch morsels. I mixed sugar and cocoa powder in a saucer and ate it one fingerful at a time.
Under the B12.
I ran upstairs and started grabbing pants out of my closet and trying them on and throwing them on the floor when they didn't fit. All those Devon pants heaped together on that green shag carpeting. All those different colors, all those different shapes, all those different sizes. Oh, I cannot do it. I cannot buy a size 18. Oh. I'd rather die. I'd rather move to Hawaii and wear this muumuu the rest of my life. Oh, please, God, please. Not a size 18. I'll do anything.
Bingo!
Oh.
Babe, are you okay, hon? My God, you're sweating like a pig.
Can't breathe. I can't breathe.
Well, here, hon. Bend over and put your head... Here, hon. Bend over and put your head down between your knees and breathe into your hands. That's it. Just relax. You're going to be all right. No, no, it's okay, Flo. I just dropped some chips on the floor and Babe's helped me pick them up.
Oh, I feel sick. I just feel sick.
Well, then sit up, hon. Lean back.
I am so disgusted with myself. It's probably something I ate.
What are you talking about?
All I want to do is stay in the house and eat and sleep.
Everybody's looking.
I don't know what I'm going to do anymore.
Get down there and help me pick up those chips. Now, you have... got to calm down a little, hon.
Calm down? I can't calm down. I almost didn't come tonight. I feel so crazy. Do I look crazy?
Well, no, hon. You don't look crazy. It's just...
What? It's just what?
Well, yeah, you do look a little crazy.
I was afraid of that. What am I gonna do?
Just take it easy.
Okay, folks, we're going to play our next special of the evening, the letter X. That's the letter X on your pink specials. And remember, you can play your yellow door card, too.
I feel like I'm gonna jump out of my skin.
I know, hon, I know.
Don't let me do it, sis.
What?
Don't let me make a fool out of myself.
Promise me, sis.
I
promise. Now just relax.
Everybody's watching me, aren't they?
No, not everybody.
What am I gonna do?
Well, just get up and watch your back. And march, 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 march. Left, right, left, right. We haven't got much bingo left, right? Just sit down. And pretend like you're playing bingo.
Oh, that's good, that's good. What do I do? What do I do?
Just do what I do and keep calm.
Our first number tonight in the letter X is, under the B, 12. B12.
I remember when I was a size 12.
What are you talking about? It's a pink special, huh?
Remember that pink R&K dress I used to have? I wore it to Marge's wedding. It was a princess style with a lace collar. That was a size 12.
Is that what this is all about? Have you been driving yourself crazy over your weight again?
It was right around the time that Joe left me, and I changed everything to try to get him back. Remember? I had frosted hair.
We've been going through this since you were in high school. Whenever you start wearing those caftans and staying in the house a lot, I know something's up. Usually your weight.
Under the eye, 25.
I lost 25 pounds. I lost 25 pounds and I kept it off. I kept it off for 3 years. How did I do that?
You stopped eating. Except for chicken.
Chicken! That's it, chicken!
For 3 years, we couldn't invite you over for dinner unless we were having chicken.
Under the B2. B2.
Oh, I've got so I can't stand the sight of chicken.
Well, neither can I.
Yeah, well, so much for that idea.
What got you on all this anyway? Up until 2 weeks ago, you were just fine, and then all of a sudden you just disappeared.
Coach Anderson called me.
What?
He called me and, well, he asked me to go to homecoming with him.
You're kidding! Well, that's great. That's really great. You'll go to the game, then you go to the dance, then who knows?
Oh, you can forget about that. I wouldn't be caught dead with my clothes off right now. I can't even go to the game looking like this.
I-18.
No, I-18. No, 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 size 18!
You missed one.
Huh?
You got an I-18 right there. You missed it.
Oh, God.
Now concentrate on the game.
Oh, I can't. I don't know what I'm going to do anymore.
Well, I thought you were still on Weight Watchers.
Oh, I can't go back there. I started over 6 times this year. Every time I get within 15 pounds of my goal weight, I hit a plateau and just stay there. At my last weigh-in, my instructor accused me of cheating. But I wasn't, sis, I wasn't. I stuck to that program every day for 2 whole weeks. And I gained 2 pounds.
Oh, well, I know, hon, I know.
No, you don't know. I've been on every diet known to man. I spent a fortune on Jenny Craig and the Nutrisystem and gained it all back. I tried the Dexatrim and the grapefruit pills and the protein bread. The Atkins diet makes me sick. That cabbage soup makes me fart like a racehorse. Chocolate Royale Slim Fast staring me in the face every time I open my cupboards. I mean, that's why I'm so crazy tonight. Sis, I was afraid I was gonna run into the coach. I mean, I haven't answered my phone all week. I'm gonna have to tell him no, but gee whiz, I sure don't want to. What am I gonna do?
We'll think of something.
Oh, I knew you would help me, sis. Oh, I can always depend on you.
Under the G54, G54.
Okay, now. Let's think about this logically. Now, first of all, you're not that big. You talk like you're the fat lady in the circus or something. I mean, take a look around you. Oh, look at the fat one, for instance.
Oh, for crying out loud, sis. She's the biggest woman here. That's like saying I smell a little better than Limburger cheese.
Okay, then Look at Marge Maransky. She's over there next to Joanne.
Under the B5. B5.
Okay, yeah, so I'm looking.
Now, she's bigger than you are.
Oh, come on, sis. She is not.
I'm telling you, she is. I saw her at Kohl's the other day, and I noticed she was trying on a size 18. Now, I know you're not that big.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't put money on it. God, she doesn't look that big.
I-27.
No, because she dresses real well for her size, and she knows how to wear clothes. There's no reason you can't look like her. You usually do, except when you get in one of your crazy moods and start wearing those house coats around.
You don't know what you're talking about. The last time I saw Coach Anderson, I was wearing this same dress. He says to me, "Gee, babe, you're looking good. Lost some weight, hey?" I said, "Coach, you have no idea what's going on underneath this moo-moo." He thought that was pretty funny.
Well, that Coach Anderson's a doll. He always did like a woman with a little meat on her bones. He thinks you're a real looker just the way you are. So you see, it's all in your head.
Don't tell me it's all in my head. Every pair of pants I own is lying on a heap on my bedroom floor, and it's not because I couldn't get them on over my head. You don't believe me, do you?
Oh, sure I do.
Oh, no, you don't. You're just like all the other skinny people in the world. You never had a diet. You never had to lose weight. You never had to feel like the Goodyear blimp. Why, it's silly to even talk to you about it. You're just like Coach Anderson and everybody else. As long as I can still stretch this piece of cloth over my body so that you can't see how fat I am, you'll just pretend that I'm not fat. But I am. I'm fat. I am. Don't you tell me I'm not fat. I am too fat. You want to see? I'll show you. I am fat!
All right, you're fat!
Just don't say that.
Now get down from there, babe.
For God's sakes, babe, get down.
Come out here and get rid of these mice. Yeah. No. It's okay, Lonnie. It was a mouse, right, babe? With a purple head, right, babe?
Yeah. Purple head.
You know how Babe is about mice. They make her crazy. Yeah, me too. Well, yeah. It's okay now, Babe. The coast is clear. Here, hun.
Let me help you down.
I can't believe I just did that. I must be going crazy.
Hun, you have got to get a grip on yourself. Play bingo.
Oh, okay, yeah, right. Okay, all right, play bingo.
You know, Babe, I read an article on Family Circle about fat cells and how some people are just born with more than others. Maybe God gave you more fat cells because that's the way he wanted you to be.
Be one.
I can't believe God would do a thing like that to me.
Bingo?
Oh.
We have a bingo, ladies and gentlemen, on the letter X. That's one winner of a special pain, $100. Get ready for our next game of regular bingo.
Look, babe, you're built just like Mom. I'm small-boned like Dad, and you're big-boned like Mom.
I beg your pardon, but did you just say big bone?
Yes, I did.
Big bone. You know, I never understood what people mean when they say that. Big bone. What exactly do you mean by big bone?
Well, it just means that your frame, your shape, your size, your skin and stuff is sort of layered over these things.
What things?
These and those.
So?
Well, it's just that sometimes certain people have bigger theses and thoses than others.
Theses and thoses. Say arms and legs.
Arms and legs.
Bones. Some people have bigger bones than other people.
Some people have bigger bones than other people.
How can you say that?
I don't know. I mean, it's not the end of the world, babe. Fat people have a right to live, too.
I don't want to hear that. I don't even believe that. That's not true. Who says that's true? Fat people don't have any rights. What books have you been reading? What magazines? Where does it say that? It doesn't say that anywhere.
Our first number is I-23.
I'm not a dumb person. I watch Oprah. The only people like fat people are a couple of weirdos called chubby chasers or voluptuous people adorers or something like that. And they're even sicker than fat people. Oh, and fat people are sick. They're sick and I'm sick. Sick. I mean, fat.
It works. Will you listen to me? You've got this whole thing way out of proportion. Fat people do have a right to live.
No, they don't.
Yes, they do. They're just people. That's all. They have a right to go to the beach and wear swimsuits.
Under the G55. G55.
They have a right to be belly dancers and take saunas. Fat people have a right to eat, too.
Under the O-74.
That's right. You can give up bingo, and you can give up drinking, and you can give up sex and religion and smoking and anything else you can think of, but you cannot give up eating. You will die. And fat people have a right to eat what they want to, too, not just Weight Watchers. They have a right to eat ice cream and layered cake and cream cheese and, pizza.
B13.
Bingo!
No,
she doesn't know what she's talking
bingo,
about.
Bingo!
Babe, stop!
I got a good bingo!
She doesn't know what she's talking about. It's a sugar level. It makes her crazy. Somebody give her a Twinkie or a Ho-Ho. For God's sake, has anybody got a ding-dong?
We have a bingo, ladies and gentlemen, in four numbers, 13, 74, 55, and 23. That's a double cash prize of $90 to our winner.
$90! That's a lot better than a turkey. Oh, that's incredible. Since when do they start paying double on four numbers?
Well, I told you there's been some changes.
Boy, that's great. That's just great. I told you, didn't I? I am hot tonight. Yes, sir. I am hot tonight. Woo!
Well, I must admit, you had me a little worried there for a minute.
I'm okay, sis. I mean, well, I'm gonna be okay.
You sure forgot about being fat, fat, fat when you were down to one number.
Well, you know how I get when I'm playing bingo. I mean, when I'm playing bingo, I can't think of anything else.
Even food?
Yeah, even food.
Okay, clear the decks, ladies and gentlemen. Get ready for the next game of regular bingo.
Well, maybe that's the answer.
What's that?
Well, you never eat when you play bingo.
Yeah, so?
Yeah, so maybe you should play bingo more often. It would get you out of the house and help you not to eat so much.
And our first number is under the N, 41. N41.
Well, they do a little walk-a-thon over at the Senior Citizen Center. After each special, they go once around the gym while they play that song, The Hokey Pokey, on the record player. That way they get their exercise and their bingo in at the same time.
Under the B10. B10.
Well, that's okay, but I got news for you. A, I don't play at the Senior Citizen Center, and B, you can't play bingo every day.
Why not?
What do you mean?
Under the G51. G51.
Well, on Monday there's a game at St. Stephen's. On Tuesday and Fridays I play here, of course. On Saturday I go to the Immaculate Heart of Mary, and on Thursday I have been known to go to the Elks.
Sis.
Under the I-23. I-23.
Now, on Sunday, I have to go all the way over to the Bingo Palace. But on Wednesday, they have the Senior Citizen game.
You play bingo every day?
I've even been to the Moose. Where do you think that dauber really came from?
Gee, that's a lot of bingo.
Look.
Is that you? You might want to try boosting the estrogen for a week or two. You're not possessed, are you?
Can I get a drink of your water?
Yeah, take a drink. Let's try it again. Crush your legs this time. Look! Look! It's not even a matinee.
You start in on me. I got the kids on my back. I don't need you, too. Besides, it's not like it's the only thing I do. I volunteer at the church 2 days a week. I serve at the soup lines Mondays and Fridays. I go to all the senior citizens events.
Okay, okay. I just can't believe you never told me. That's all.
You never asked. Listen, babe, think about it. Now, I'm not saying bingo's the answer to all the world's problems, but it sure gives me something to look forward to every day.
I don't know. How can you afford it?
Under the N, 39. N39.
Well, I figure I pretty much break even. That's better than any other recreational activity I know of.
Under the B15. B15.
Oh, I don't know. That's all I need is to be sitting around on my fat buttinski every night of the week.
You know, you don't have to be a senior citizen to do the walk at the Senior Citizen Center. As a matter of fact, Coach Anderson usually leads the group.
Oh, come on now, sis. I can't think about that until I don't know. I mean, until I lose just a little bit more weight.
Under the G47. G47.
Well, now listen. The Bingo Palace is right next to a Jack Lane. Marge and Joanne take the 5:30 jazzercise class there before they come to bingo. They've been trying to get me to go. They say it's a lot of fun.
Under the I-22. I-22.
You know, I think Joanne is a lifer at Overeaters Anonymous. I mean, maybe she'd be my sponsor. And who knows? I might even start answering my phone again.
Oh, that's the spirit, sweetie.
I mean, look, so I've got this problem. What am I supposed to do, stop living?
But I promise I'll never eat chocolate in front of you again. It's the least I can do.
Under the 075, 075.
I'll count calories, but this time I'll be sensible.
Or donuts.
1,400 a day.
But I can't give up real pop.
That way I'll lose real slow and keep it off.
That diet stuff leaves the worst taste in my mouth.
Just like Joanne, she's a doll. She'll help me.
And I'll take the jazzercise if you will.
Oh, sis, jazzercise. Listen to you. You're skinny enough already.
Skinny schminny, I need the exercise. Get the blood moving.
Sis, what would I do without you?
Under the B1. B1.
Oh, and listen, hon. Lonnie was telling me that the Elks are chartering a bus the first Saturday of next month. They're going to that Indian reservation up near the Wisconsin Dells. They put you up at a Motel 6, which is right across the street from a Ponderosa.
Under the I-29. I-29.
Now, you have to pay for your own meals, but the coveralls, they pay $1,000 each. And they even give away a Cadillac. Well, it sounds wonderful, don't you think?
Do they have a salad bar at Ponderosa?
Oh, they got a great salad bar at Ponderosa. I saw it on TV.
So where do we sign up?
Oh, good. I was hoping you'd want to go. I was afraid for a while there you were going to quit on me, but you still want to play bingo, huh, hon?
Do bears shit in the woods? Is the Pope a Catholic?
That's my babe!
Under the O, 67. Oh, 67.
Give the queen a dollar!
Thank you, oh. Ladies.
Sis, look at your card.
Bingo!
Sisters, sisters, there were never such devoted sisters. Never had to have a chaperone, no sir. I'm here to keep my eye on her. Caring, sharing,
wearing. All right, now where's Peter? Peter, put your hand up. Peter, come on right over here, sir. Come on up here. I told you I was going to give you the bird. That's what I'm going to do right now. Round of applause one more time for Peter, a winner. All right, sir, come on up right next to our ladies. We're going to take a picture for the website. It's www.thequeenofbingo.com. Here you are, Peter. Here's your bird. Get right in between our hot ladies over here. Let me get the camera ready here. Oh, look at a face like that. He's already on the internet, folks. All right. On the count of three, say bingo. One, two, three.
Bingo.
Beautiful.
Congratulations.
Thank you very much, Peter. Now, here you are, sir. One more round of applause for our lovely ladies. Thank you, Peter.
Many men have tried to split us up, but